So our problem is when two cars of mass one, of mass M1 and M2 respectively are moving at right angles to each other, both with speed V initial. They hit in an intersection and they stick together in a right angle here. Find the final speed and angle theta of the two cars in terms of the variables. The conservation of momentum equation is M1 V1 plus M2 V2 is equal to MV. And because of this, and because we know that the two velocities are equal to each other, we can replace this with VI. So we would have the equation M1 VI plus M2 VI equals MV. So because we are given the fact that the masses are equal to each other, and because we know the conservation of momentum equation, we also know that the final momentum is going to be equal to the momentum of this car and the momentum of this car once they stick together. So once we start looking at it, we know that because we're given these, we can form a right triangle here. So then we can have with our velocity final here and our angle theta here. So we know that because of this, we can do the Pythagorean theorem where we have VF equal to P1 squared plus P2 squared equals VF squared, which means that we can define VF as equal to the square root of P1 squared plus P2 squared. We can also say, since we have P1 and P2, we can also define this as P3, which means that if we set it up in terms of the Pythagorean theorem, that P3 ends up being equal to M1 plus M2 times the velocity final. So with that, we can move some things around, and we end up with M1 plus M2 VF is equal to the square root of M1 V1 squared plus M2 V2 squared. So we can divide some things out, so we end up with the velocity final equal to square root of m times the velocity initial, because we defined earlier, we have our velocity initial, we've pulled it out now. And then we can also say that with our division, that all over m1 plus m2. So this can be simplified further, and overall we get velocity final is equal to VI plus square root of 2 all over 2. So that is our final value for the velocity final in terms of our variables. So now that we have that, we can also find our tangent value, which is the other thing that we need to find. So again, we make use of the Pythagorean theorem and set it again. So we have P3 is equal, P3 squared is equal to P1 plus P2 squared. Then we know that P3, again, as we said it earlier, is equal to the square root of P1 squared plus P2 squared. Then, because we know that we have tangent, which is opposite over adjacent, we can say that tangent of theta is equal to P2 over P1. And then with that, because we want to find the angle theta, we can then say that arctan, or inverse tangent, of P1 over P2 is equal to our angle theta. So that's our second value that we were looking for in terms of our other equations. So for our first case, where m1 is greater than m2, we know that when there's a larger number over a smaller number, we get a number that's bigger or greater than 1. So then we can there look at this and say that because of our overall values and the definition of our right triangle, we can assume that theta, in this case, is going to be greater than 45. And this is vice versa for the next case, where we have a smaller number over a larger number. And we can then, because it's less than 1, we can assume that it is theta is less than 45. And if we have m1 equal m2 and they're both hitting at right angles, giving a tangential velocity, we can say that theta would be equal to 45. So those are the values for all of our three cases, depending on our momentums of the first car, the second car, and our final momentum from the right triangle.